Hello everybody, my name is Mohammad Hashim and I am from R&D Engineering College, currently pursuing Electronics and Instrumentation Engineering, and today I am here to demonstrate my project, which is namely known as face mask detector. This detector could also be used in various industries and institutions where mask etiquette is a major concern.
Well, on today's agenda we have the following points, and to talk about the project, we have made this project as a concern to the major problem which we are facing today. As you all are aware that this COVID-19 has taken the world over and it has brought into a standstill. Also, this disease is airborne, which means that this virus spreads through air. So researchers and scholars have suggested that wearing a mask could prevent one from being infected by this disease, and it is also the need of the hour, as many medical industries are working effectively and fastly such that they find the cure of this virus. So on this regard, we'll be talking about a prototype which we have made to detect the faces whether the people are wearing mask or not. As you all know, it is a difficult task to monitor individually whether people are wearing masks or not, and it has become an important task for the people to cover their faces with masks and move outside. So we'll be talking to talk about the prototype's architecture and design. The major components of this project is the Raspberry Pi. Under this Raspberry Pi, we have two other models, which is the face detector and the mask detector, which we'll be covering up in the later slides. The next is the speaker, a camera, and a monitor. Now, a speaker is used to alert the administrator in case if the person is not wearing a mask, as we detect faces and perform mathematical operation. It is required that we install camera as well. A monitor is used to visualize the screen in case if the person is not wearing a mask. For example, in the video you'll be watching, you'll see that a person not wearing a mask will be bounded by a red box, whereas a person wearing a mask will be bounded by a green box. So as an example, this is a project structure. Here this is a camera. A camera's output is given as input to the Raspberry Pi module, in which each frame is passed as the input to the face detector model, which detects the faces. Then the detected faces are passed to a mask detector model, which detects whether the predicted face is wearing a mask or not. Further on that calculation, in case if the person is not wearing a mask, it gives out the alert or the alarm message to the admin. Else, that's nothing. It just shows a green bounding box. In addition to that, you could also transfer images of the people via mail, which we'll be showing out in the later slides as well. So to talk about the mask detector model architecture, which we have trained on various images, to be precise, 1,376 images were used to train this model to develop this model. As you all can see, that the head model of this architecture is the MobileNet V2. Well, this is a most standardized and regularized model which is used in deep learning concepts. This is a type of architecture which is convenient and effective to use as well, since it could be deployed in various architectures and various mobile devices as well to simplify the mathematical operations. Then after further training and compiling the model, we generate a complete model with its weight. Now this model is saved and loaded again in case if you want to use it. Now to improve the model's performance and efficiency, we have also deployed threading and alert system as well as mail concepts to improve the prototype's architecture. On deploying, live images or camera input is given as the input to the model, which detects whether the faces are wearing mask or not. Then based on that observation, bounding boxes will be generated, and two probabilities, P1 and P2, which says P1 is wearing mask and P2 is not wearing mask. It is really simple. In case if P1 is greater than P2, the computer understands that the person is wearing mask, whereas if P2 is greater than P1, it indicates 0, which tells us that the person is not wearing a mask, and based on that calculation, bounding boxes are generated. And the project demonstration will be shown in the video.
As said earlier, we'll be using a Raspberry Pi module to demonstrate this project. Well, this is a Raspberry Pi module which has a limited capabilities, and this is of a 4GB RAM. It has limited computational qualities, but it shows better performance than previous modules. Then we'll be using a speaker to alert the administrator in case if a person is not wearing a mask, and then we'll be using a camera to detect the faces and to do mathematical operations. So let's see how it works.
And another marketing requirement, as you all are aware that educating people in this nation is really difficult, and though being under a lockdown for the past 3 months, we still find people walking around without masks, and it is important that we educate people, but it is a really difficult task. Hence we could just take this prototype at this we could just take this prototype put this into a difficult situation where monitoring people is really difficult. So through this, one could be able to perform and secure himself and could protect itself from being infected by this deadly virus. Cure of this virus is not yet been discovered, but we could defeat this deadly virus and win against this by joining our hands together and fighting against this virus.